Alright, welcome back to more of Zelda 1 Deluxe. Okay, we're gonna head on to level 9. Again, that's a fairly lengthy level, so I'll probably split into two parts. I'll kind of have to see how I do on time. Level 9, I kind of already pointed out where it's located. And again, it's not in the old spot for it. It pretty much is in the upper left corner. Again, it's a lot easier when you've already kind of cleared out most of these screens. You know, just leaving one enemy behind. Okay, level 9, the upper left corner. Again, you need to just need Iron Glove to get into this place. I may not explore everything right off the bat. I might just go get the two items in this place. Yeah, I didn't get a key for that. Kind of useless because I got the magic key already. Level 4 land molas. Again, I'll explore all that later, the rest of this place. You really don't have to explore too much of this level to get to the end. Okay, now you actually do want to go towards the kind of dead-end path here because one of the items is on this side. And a good source of refills. Might as well just pick up more money. Not that I really can do anything with this. kind of just doing some scouting in this area. Yeah, so you got the different colored Pole's voice. Because it just matches the color of the, you know, the background walls. Locked doors are kind of irrelevant at this point. They got a magic key. I think normally you'd never go this way. You know, there'd be no reason to go this way in the original Zelda. It's just a dead end. Might as well just grind off of these guys. Just get more money and, you know, bombs if I find any. Seven bombs there, actually. I might still hold that, actually. So it's not totally useless. Now, this one can be a little bit tricky. Like level 4 enemies. You wouldn't even be wrong using super bombs if you had any. I didn't actually buy extra super bombs to use. Oh, thank you, Whimsical Ring. Not complaining about cheap kills here. And again, Whimsical Ring critical, that's an instant kill. Whimsical Ring making things a little bit easier there. Yeah, this is why you want to go on the detour. Getting the Master Sword is always a big plus there. Actually lets you knock out these guys in one hit now. in this room. That's three of these, the dongos. Again, luckily they don't hit like the right edge or the bottom edge. Kind of use that to your advantage, you know, where you can kind of stand safely. Oh, never mind grinding away at this. Clock you to free pass through this. You just beat these guys up. Another half potion that I don't really need. Can't carry any more than two half potions. Chances for refills. So if you're ever low on life, you know, usually you find at least a few of these rooms with a bunch of bat ropes in them. There's a chance to get your health back up. Loaded up on bombs. I mean, that took long enough. Really, just because I had to use so many of them up. Not just to get back to this room. Thank you. A lot of these rooms you can actually skip. I think this one you just need money for beating all the enemies in this room. Loading up on cash. Half of these rooms have free money in them. If I try to do this in one go, I'm obviously going to have to break this into two videos. Which I might do that just to be more, just more convenient. I got one of them out of the way. Look at all this money dropping. Got free money there. Level 3 Patra. Well, I guess you know it better as the level 2 Patra. Because you're level 3 here. So it's a oval, but it's a, you know, level 2. Yeah, having Master Sword kind of helps. Makes things a little quicker. That is a full potion that I just got right there. Again, not that I need it, I already maxed out my potions. Alright, this room has... Oh, splitters. That's gonna be fun. Yeah, it gets a little hectic here. After you, I mean, you don't have to clear out the room, but it just makes it a little bit easier to get to the stairs. Okay, so we get, which I think looks like a purple ring. I think it's supposed to be a purple ring. No, I'm not sure why I didn't just use the red ring, but, you know, whatever. Level 4 armor. It makes things a little more bearable going through this place now. And this passage down here, I don't think really leads to much. I think just a couple extra keys that I don't really need. Just to be complete, just go through these rooms. Here because I'm maybe not even halfway through this place yet. But I know there are dead-end rooms and at least a dead-end path, so I want to at least go on that first. Three dig doggers to deal with. Which is like really no issue, you just clock out the room.